Hello, my name is Akira Tazawa. Today, I am going to talk about United Nations. The United Nations was established based on reflection of the League of Nations, which was not able to prevent World War II at the member nation of 51 countries on October 24, 1945. The member nation has 193 countries now. The name United Nations was devised by Franklin D. Roosevelt during World War II. He was President of the United States. The representative is Antonio Guterres. The head office is Manhattan in New York. There are three purposes of United Nations. First, maintenance of international peace and security. Second, development of the friendly relationship between the countries. Third, international cooperation to solve these problems that there are economical, social, cultural, and humanitarian. In addition, international collaboration for the promotion of the basic freedom and human rights. There are six major institutions. General Assembly, Security Council, Economic and Social Council, Trans-TCIP Council, International Court of Justice, and Secretariat to achieve these purposes. In addition, many additional institutions and subsidiary bodies are located. I would like to explain Security Council among them. Please look at this picture. It is Security Council in 2020. Security Council is composed of 5 permanent member countries and 10 non-permanent member countries. Permanent member countries are China, France, Russia, UK, and US. This member has not changed since 1945, but non-permanent member countries are changed every year. Non-permanent member countries are Colombia, Germany, India, Portugal, South Africa, Bosnia, Brazil, Gabon, Lebanon, and Nigeria. I think that the United Nations has many problems. First, adoption by the combination with 5 permanent member countries and 10 non-permanent member countries determines it for voting of the United Nations. But all the adoption is rejected when permanent member vetoes it. Second, there is no change of permanent members. These countries is determined to have a grave responsibility for maintaining world peace and security. However, the US possesses nuclear weapons, so I think can't be said to maintain peace and security. Third, this is called enemy crisis, and there is the decision which I can invade without the decision of the Security Council of the United Nations about Japan and Germany of the defeated nation of World War II determined by this crisis. Furthermore, The attack can do the rule of the United Nations by any attack because it is not adapted. I give the solution to these problems. The first is the abolition of the veto. I think that the opinion of the non-permanent member countries comes to be reflected by abolishing it. In addition, I think that they are in an equal situation and can perform talks smoothly. The second is change of the permanent member countries. The non-permanent member countries have a change once a year, but the permanent member does not have it. The opinion of many countries when they are changed every approximately 5 years and thinks that it leads to maintenance of the world peace and security. The third is the abolition of the enemy clauses. Only Japan and Germany become disadvantaged, and these clauses can attack many countries without decision. The United Nations is formed for the purpose of maintenance of the world peace and security. Therefore, I felt that you should abolish such a clause immediately. In addition, I felt that you should abolish the article which supported a specific country. The fourth is nuclear abolition of a country joining the United Nations. The United Nations aims for maintenance of the world peace and security. However, some member nations possess a nuclear and are very in danger. Besides, I may develop into war for nuclear. I thought that the United Nations should push for the meeting that abolished a nuclear as soon as possible. I researched the United Nations this time. I think that these problems should be solved as soon as possible. I think that World War III can happen if the United Nations is not established after World War II. In belief that untitled United Nations keep world space. However, I felt that there were still many problems. In addition, there is the differences depending on a country and things that they should do all it equally. The United Nations abolishes a nuclear as soon as possible and should advance with the goal of maintenance of the world peace and security. How about you researching the United Nations? Thank you for watching this video.